many of us, it's a huge accomplishment just to get outside our comfort zone and visit someplace new. Well, our next guest took that thinking to the extreme.
So recently, 27-year-old Cassandra De Pecol shattered two Guinness World Records by becoming the first female to visit every country in the world in the shortest amount of time. Her journey took her to get this 196 countries, that's all of them, over the span of 18 months.
Wow.
So Cassie joins us now via Skype. You're out in Connecticut. Good morning, Cassie.
Hello.
Morning. Thanks for having me. Appreciate it.
It's a fascinating story. So you have this record. You visited all these places. Where the heck did you get this idea to do this?
It came up kind of in high school. I wanted to travel to every country in the world, but the idea didn't really come to fruition until my mid-20s. I kind of had a quarter-life crisis. I think that exists.
Oh, yeah.
What am I doing? My career? Where am I going? So I was like, I have to actually make this happen. And that's where I thought, okay, I'll go to every country and I'll do so for a purpose and I'll try and change the world. And that's how it kind of came about.
And obviously travel costs a lot of money, but you funded it in a really unique way. Tell us about that.
Yeah, so I don't think people realize the amount of work that went into it. I talk about sponsors, I talk about independent investors, but in that year and a half before I took off, I had to save up. I saved about $10,000 for my two babysitting jobs. I was working like 85 hours a week, overnights, but just so that I could kind of save up that first bit to just get me going. But in that time, I also reached out to CEOs and companies and network to try and find the funding through sponsorship and through independent investors to fund the remainder of the trip. And, 8 months in, I completely ran out of what I'd saved so far and what I'd made so far. And so I had to kind of go back home and regroup and figure, okay, I'm going to have to focus on financing this throughout like every single day. I'm going to have to continue to reach out to companies for sponsorship. So it was no easy feat. It was definitely really challenging. But worth it.
And quickly, what was the grand total of how much it was?
Yeah, I just finished the budgeting and it was $110,000 total.
Oh, wow. Which is a lot. And don't get me wrong, no one's got that change lying around. But to travel the whole world, it's got to be amazing. And
that's
you must
true.
Have learned so much, which is worth more than any dollar amount. So can you tell us a couple of the big takeaways from your journey? When you come back here, what do you look back and say, oh, I learned this?
I think this is something where it kind of could sound cheesy, but one thing I realize is, I went into this expedition feeling kind of maybe a little bit selfish and not like I was able to help the world, and I didn't really understand humanity fully. But after traveling to so many countries and connecting with so many people and being in situations where I've been completely stuck having to depend on locals, I truly realized that we all have the same basic needs. Everyone around the world, women, we have families, we want a hot meal on our plate, we want to have a roof over our head, we just want these basic necessities. And once we can kind of realize this underlying foundation of humanity, we can learn to respect each other a little bit more and be a little bit more kind of open-minded as well to learning about new cultures and religions and everything like that. So that's kind of my major takeaway, I'd say, is I'm a little bit more open-minded and respectful of people to learn their story as well. It's really important because then you can learn so much about humanity and just the different types of people that are so amazing from around the world.
That is one of the best things about travel, is realizing that we're more similar than we are different. But was there a place that maybe took you a little bit by surprise?
There was Pakistan, I think, most recently. There have been a lot of situations that I've been in and countries that have proven to be really surprising, but most recently it was definitely Pakistan. I like to talk about Pakistan because it kind of has a certain image in the media. People think it's really dangerous and they would never go there, but it's a place that I always wanted to go. And I, for some reason, I never believe it to be true, that the danger factor of all these places. And it's like when I arrived there, I went to Karachi, Lahore, Islamabad, and I was really just taken into the arms of the people there. They're so smart, they're so kind, the food is amazing, different ecosystems. I felt completely safe and fine, even like walking around on my own. I didn't have to cover up like I did in Afghanistan. And so it was a really, really beautiful experience in Pakistan, and I go back there in a heartbeat.
Okay.